So this is the payment mechanism. So first understand the first party, second party and third party arrangement. First party is the patient, second party is the dentist, third party is the insurer, carrier or administrator. So the payment mechanism is how the patient pays to the third party or insurance company, and the reimbursement mechanism is how the third party is reimbursing to the second party, that is dentist. So the payment mechanism, this is a prepayment mechanism system. So the first method is deductible, second is coinsurance, third is group insurance. In deductible, we have a fixed amount, that is front-end payment for particular coverage. So if it is 10,000 premium and we have a 1 lakh coverage, so if the cost is around 60,000 or 70,000, 80,000, let it be any amount up to 1 lakh, we have to pay only 10,000. The coinsurance is like co-payment or sharing scenario. So we have to share 30% of the total cost. If it is 1 lakh, we have to share 30,000 and we will be getting only 70,000. If it is 50,000, we have to bear the 30,000. 30% that will be 15,000 and the insurance will be for 35,000. It will be 30 to 70. So it is just an example. It can be in any sequence. Only thing is coinsurance. The patient has to bear a fixed amount of percentage of total cost. Group insurance, as I discussed, it is for the groups for students in a particular class or any institute or any rehabilitation center or such things. So this is a payment mechanism. Next is a reimbursement mechanism. Reimbursement mechanism is how the third party is giving to dentist or reimbursing the dentist. The first concept is UCR concept, that will be dealt in detail, usual, customary and reasonable. Second one is table of allowances. Third one is fee schedules. Table of allowances is nothing like, sometimes there is a problem, dentist fee greater than the allowances they receive, so patient has to pay extra amount to match up with the dentist fee. So that is a problem. Fee schedules, like the schedules will be there for each service, but the mean payment will be taken as a reimbursement. Since it is inflexible and there is no autonomy, it is not very accepted by the dentist. Okay, so this is table of allowances, fee schedule and UCR. So the only thing we need to understand is this is a payment mechanism, this is a reimbursement mechanism, this is a payment mechanism, this is a reimbursement mechanism. So if you have this idea of first party, second party, third party, this will be pretty much easier to understand.